Here on the Darling Downs, grain growers have some of the most fertile land in the country. Elsewhere, if it wasn't for fertilisers, things would be pretty grim. So research that's showing how the placement of nutrients directly into the subsoil layer can improve yield for the next four or five crops should have a positive impact for grain growers everywhere.
A crop reaching its full potential requires adequate sunlight, water, and nutrients. While the weather is outside our control, we can manipulate the availability of nutrients. But how do we ensure the plants can access them, particularly in the dryland farming systems of the north?
We probably have a greater reliance on stored soil moisture deeper in the profile than in-crop rainfall in most years. And so nutrients in where the subsoil moisture is a critical part of the success of this cropping system.
With surface fertiliser applications positioning nutrients in the top layers of the soil, how do we ensure nutrients are in the subsoil layers? Fortunately, some nutrients are easy to manage. They're mobile in the soil, so they move where the water moves.
The mobile nutrients like nitrogen and sulphur, you can wait until the crop's about to be sown and you can put them on and you know that they'll redistribute with water and they'll go wherever the crop roots go.
Phosphorus and potassium, however, are immobile in the soil. Where you put them is where they stay. So if your plants are living on subsoil moisture, a surface application of these nutrients might not hit the mark.
Once the plant grows away from that 0 to 10 centimetre layer, there's very little available nutrient for the plant to use, and so it runs out of steam almost.
Phosphorus is the one that's most widespread because a number of these soils had marginal reserves to start with, and so those reserves are now starting to run out.
That's why GRDC-funded research into the deep placement of fertiliser is sparking the interest of growers in the north. Experimentation involves placing phosphorus deeper in the soil profile and measuring the results in combination with and without the placement of other nutrients.
Starter P gives the crop early crop vigour, sets up grain number and some of those important parameters to set the yield potential. But what we think this deep phosphorus placement does is gives the plant a bigger pool of nutrient to use to actually grow out on.
The idea is to minimise soil disruption.
We're trying to put enough phosphorus down to last two, three, maybe four crops at a time so that we don't have to cultivate very often. We don't want to cultivate very often, but occasionally we're going to have to replace some of what we're removing in those subsoils to keep the cropping system running.
Developing the principles starts in the glasshouse.
We've got nutrients applied in subsoil, either in one band or two bands or in a layer, and we're looking at how crops respond to those subsoil nutrients when they can't get out of dry topsoil. We've also got capillary tubes inserted in the fertiliser band so we can see what's actually going on in there and relate that to how crop roots respond to those bands.
Field testing is confirming the theory and shows the subsoil placement of nutrients lasts a number of crop cycles.
We had a site at Brookstead on the Darling Downs where we monitored it for five or six crops in sequence. And the crop responses there are about 15% on average, year in, year out, over and above the standard practice. And that site has shown no signs of giving up on that one-off P application running out.
Responses have averaged around 20%, though they can be as high as 70%.
We've even seen those responses with crops like chickpeas, where we've got a really big yield response to getting the right mix of nutrients. Maybe two, three tonnes of sorghum in some instances. So big response, big dollars, but you know, that extra nutrient input into the cropping system is also expensive.
The research examines responses of multiple nutrients placed at different levels.
We've taken a machine that InciTech Pivot originally developed and we've modified it to allow us to achieve these deep placement levels with it.
But growers can experiment themselves and they don't have to buy expensive equipment to do it.
So this is one of our cheaper homegrown versions where we realised that we could get away with a bit more soil disturbance. So we modified a deep ripper or a chisel plough, putting an old combine box on top, and allowed us to get flexibility of band spacing and also the deep placement that we were after.
If you're going to experiment, make sure you do it right.
What they can do is set up a bar that they have meter row spacings on and they'll use that this year, and then 2 or 3 or 4 years' time, whenever the opportunity arises for them again, offset it by 50 centimetres and fill in the gap between those metre rows.
Another recommendation for growers wanting to apply this research is to soil test so the right paddock is selected. And don't treat the whole paddock because a reference point is needed to measure the response against. Growers are under constant pressure to find more efficient ways to produce higher yielding crops. Fertiliser application involving deep placement is one way that can be achieved.
What you're trying to do is set your soil up so that whatever set of seasonal conditions come, you can maximise your crop productivity. So if it's a wet season and the crops only need nutrients that deep, you're covered. But if it's a dry season and they need to get access to some subsoil reserves, you've got some down there as well.